Welcome to Mastering Solutions. In this projectile motion problem, they tell us that we have a rifle that's aimed horizontally at a target 50 meters away. So we'll draw a little distance here. And then we'll say that this distance, as we just talked about, is 50 meters. And they say that the bullet, after we fire it, hits a target that's 2 centimeters below the aim point. So we have to figure out what is the flight time of the bullet and the speed of the bullet as it left the barrel. So we're trying to solve for the velocity, and we're trying to solve for the time that the bullet was in the air. From the question, there's one other piece of information that we can put in here. They tell us that they're aiming for right here, but it actually hits 2 centimeters below down here. So we'll say that this delta y is 2 centimeters. And why don't we say where they're aiming that is y equals 0. And then down here is y final. So this is y initial. And that is 2 centimeters, but we can say that differently. It's the same thing to say 2 times 10 to the negative 2 meters, or we can move the decimal place over 2. So we have 0.02 meters. All of these are saying 2 centimeters. It's the exact same thing. All of them will also be negative because we're going in the negative y direction. So for part A, to find the flight time, what we're going to use is the y component of the bullet's velocity to solve for time. The equation that we'll be using, we've used it on a bunch of these other projectile motion problems to solve for time. So y final is equal to y initial plus initial velocity in the y direction times time plus 1/2 the acceleration times the time squared. The initial y, as we talked about over here, is 0, so that can go to 0. The initial velocity in the y direction is also 0. Don't get confused for this, because this is the initial velocity in the x direction, and they are completely different, the x and the y components of the velocity here. So y final is equal to 1/2 the acceleration times the time squared, and then we'll multiply both sides of the equation by 2, which is the reciprocal of 1/2, or 2 over 1. So now we have 2 times y final is equal to acceleration times the time squared. We'll divide both sides of the equation by acceleration. So now if we come up here, we have time squared is equal to 2 times the y final divided by the acceleration. And of course, we'll take the square root of both sides of the equation. So time is finally equal to the square root of 2 times the y final divided by acceleration. So we have the square root of 2 times the y final, we said, is negative 2 times 2 meters. And then the acceleration for the y direction is only gravity, so it's a negative g, so a negative 9.8 meters per second squared. So we have the square root of 2 times negative 2 times 10 to the negative 2, and then we'll divide that by gravity, which we said is a negative 9.8 meters per second squared. So the time that the bullet is in the air is 0.0639 seconds. Look at how your question asks for it. If they want you to round it a little differently, I'm going to leave it at this because I don't want to get a rounding error for the bullet speed. And in my experience, when I would plug in the longer answer into Mastering Physics, it would round the question for me, but your professor might be able to change the settings or something like that. So put in whatever your question asks for, but this is the time for the bullet in the air. Now let's give us a little bit more room and figure out the speed as it left the barrel. So now what we're wanting to find is the initial velocity in the x direction. That's our goal. And so the equation that we'll use to find that is x final is equal to x initial plus the initial velocity in the x, so that's our goal right there, times the time plus 1/2 the acceleration times the time squared. The acceleration, now looking at the x direction, is 0. It's not speeding up or slowing down. The entire time that the bullet is in the air, the initial x, the velocity in the x direction will stay constant. Right when it's fired out of the rifle, it hasn't gone anywhere, and so the x initial will also be 0. So we have x final is equal to velocity in the x component times time. If you look at this, hopefully you'll think to yourself, wow, that looks a lot like the velocity equation, because it is. The velocity equation, if we wrote it differently, would be velocity is equal to delta x over delta t. But if we move t over, then we'll have the delta x is equal to the velocity times the time. But as we talked about, the x initial is zero. So if we were to break this up, x final minus x initial, the x initial is gone. So we would have this exact theme that we got right here. So either way you go, it's just to show you that the kinematic equations always will give you the same answer as long as you do the math correctly. If you have all the variables except for the one that you're looking for, in this case, the initial velocity in the x direction, it will give you the exact same answer. So don't stress if you picked a different equation than I did. So now we'll use the x final, and the initial velocity in the x direction is what we're trying to solve for. Vix times time. So let's divide both sides of the equation by time. So Vix is equal to x final, which we said was 50 meters. And then we'll divide that by the time, which we said is 0.0639 seconds. So we have 50 divided by 0.0639 gives us an initial velocity for the bullet of 782 meters per second. 782, which will round to 780 meters per second. So again, it's up to you if you want to plug in the correct significant figures portion, or if you want to plug in the whole thing and allow Mastering Physics to round it for you. It's your call. But this is the answer for the question, 780 meters per second for the initial velocity out of the barrel.